Hey, what's up, guys? It's Jared from Valorant Update, and today we got a bunch more lore teasers aimed towards the new agent Deadeye. We got another look today at what seems to be a piece of the business card. As you can see in the top right corner, it looks like some type of emblem, and today we got an actual picture of what the emblem looks like up close. In this newest update, they made the business card an in-game interactable object, which you can pick up near the attacker spawn. To me, it looks like an eyeball on top of a crown, and when I thought about it, there was another agent that also had an eyeball on one of his emblems. Cypher has an eyeball on the middle of his chest, and we're not entirely sure what exactly the origin is for it. What we do know is the most recent teaser for Deadeye was heavily based around Cypher. As you can see, he shoots a sniper rifle that also puts off a pink bullet like you saw in the cinematic. The bullet eventually travels back and strikes Cypher, which causes him to fall through some glass, and you see a whole bunch of different reflections ending in the final teaser for Deadeye. With the teaser heavily involving Cypher and both of them having an eyeball on their business card and the emblem on Cypher's chest, maybe there's a possibility that there is a linkage between the two of them. There was also some classical lounge music added to the range, which in my opinion is a teaser for Deadeye, since we know that this guy is super classy. We know that Riot has slowly been adding this basement over time, and with each update they add something new, so maybe by the time Deadeye comes out, we'll find out that this is actually his hideout. As for the emails on Fracture, we got two new emails, and it looks like Oren and Ruben are in some serious trouble. The first email is sent to Oren from the KSEC security team, asking Oren to report to a mandatory security screening at 0700 tomorrow. The second email is from Oren to Ruben Pontes, and this email is sent after Oren already had attended the security meeting. Oren asks Ruben Pontes if he was also called to do a security check. And while Oren was worried that it was something that him and Ruben had done, it turned out that their chief engineer had gone missing. And if you take a look at the security station, it's been updated to reflect that the chief engineer is missing. If you plug these numbers into a substitution cipher, it makes up the message, "We suspect foul play." And it's apparent that Kingdom Corporation thinks that Ruben Pontes and Oren Makinoff had something to do with his disappearance because they added two new voice lines to Fracture in direct relation to that.
Chief Engineer Thomas Poe has been confirmed missing. Personnel familiar with Poe must report to KSEC. Oren McKinnon and Ruben Pontes, please report to Human Resources.
With Oren and Ruben working towards repairing the collider that Deadeye previously tried to destroy, I think that Deadeye is trying to set up Oren and Ruben and get them both removed so that he can work towards getting the facility shut down again. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video, hit that subscribe button if you're interested in more of my Valorant content, and as always, my name is Jared, and I will see you guys next time.